Hello, this is Liz Ward, Vice President for Surveillance and Health Policy Research here at the American Cancer Society. As you've probably heard, the Society recently released two of its signature scientific publications, Cancer Facts and Figures and Cancer Statistics. These publications provide concise summaries of important cancer statistics in a consumer-friendly format and are useful resources to all Society staff. This presentation highlights some of the most important information in this year's Cancer Facts and Figures and Cancer Statistics publications. Let's start with talking about death rates, really the most important way to measure progress against cancer. Unlike cancer incidence, which can be affected by changes in screening patterns and numbers of deaths, which are affected by aging and growth of the population, cancer death rates truly reflect the impact of changes like prevention, early detection, and improvements in treatment. Cancer accounts for nearly one quarter of deaths in the United States, exceeded only by heart diseases. In 2007, there were 562,875 cancer deaths in the U.S. Compared to a peak rate of 215.1 per 100,000 in 1991, the cancer death rate decreased 17% to 178.4 per 100,000 in 2007. Rates for other major chronic diseases also decreased substantially during this period. Lung cancer is by far the most common cause of cancer death in men, causing 29% of cancer deaths, followed by prostate at 11% and colorectal at 9%. In women, lung at 26%, breast 15%, and colorectal cancer 9% are the leading sites of cancer death. The death rate from all cancers combined decreased by 2% per year from 2001 to 2006 in men, and 1.5% per year from 2002 to 2006 in women. Cancer death rates have been decreasing since 1990 in men and since 1991 in women. Compared to the peak rates in 1990 for men and 1991 for women, the cancer death rate for all sites combined in 2006 was 21% lower in men and 12.3% lower in women. Despite a continuing decline in the cancer death rate from 2006 to 2007, there was an increase in the recorded number of cancer deaths in 2007 compared to 2006 as a result of the aging and growth of the U.S. population. The number of cancer deaths increased by over 2,700 in men and 200 in women, resulting in a net increase of nearly 3,000 cancer deaths. Most of the increase in cancer deaths for men prior to 1990 was attributable to increases in lung cancer deaths. However, since 1990, the age-adjusted lung cancer death rate in men has been decreasing. This decrease is estimated to account for about 40% of the overall decrease in cancer deaths in men. Stomach cancer mortality has also declined considerably since 1930. While death rates for prostate and colorectal cancers have been declining in recent decades. Lung cancer death rates in women have leveled off after rapidly increasing for several decades. The gender difference in the pattern of lung cancer occurred because smoking rates peaked in women several decades later than men. In comparison, breast cancer death rates changed very little between 1930 and 1990, but decreased substantially by a total of 29% between 1990 and 2006. The death rates for stomach and uterine cancers have decreased steadily since 1930, while colorectal cancer death rates have been decreasing for more than 50 years. Declines in death rates since the early 1990s have had an important impact in averting or postponing deaths from cancer. We estimate that over 561,000 deaths in men and 205,000 deaths in women have been averted or postponed. Cancer death rates are higher in men than in women in every racial and ethnic group. African-American men and women have higher rates of cancer mortality than their counterparts in every other racial and ethnic group. Asian American and Pacific Islander men and women have the lowest cancer death rates, about half the rate of African American men and women, respectively. It's important to note that rates for populations other than whites and African Americans may be affected by problems in ascertaining race ethnicity information from medical records. This is likely to result in lower reported death rates than are actually true. Although overall cancer death rates continue to be higher in African American men than white men, since 1997, the decline in death rates has been larger for African American than for white men, 2.6% per year compared to 1.6% per year. Turning our attention now to cancer incidence, which is the number of newly diagnosed cases rather than the number of deaths each year, it is estimated that there will be about 1.5 million new cases of cancer diagnosed in 2010. Cancers of the prostate and breast will be the most frequently diagnosed cancers in men and women, respectively, followed by lung and colorectal cancers in both men and women. This slide shows trends in cancer incidence for all sites combined for the years 1975 to 2006. Overall, incidence rates for all racial and ethnic populations combined decreased by 0.7% per year through 1999, from 1999 through 2006, in both sexes combined, by 1.3% per year from 2000 to 2006 in men, and by 0.5% per year from 1998 through 2006 in women. Incidence rates of prostate cancer have changed substantially over the last 20 years, rapidly increasing from 1988 to 1992, declining sharply from 1992 to 1995, remaining stable from 1995 to 2000, and decreasing from 2000 to 2006, largely due to changes in prostate cancer screening with PSA blood testing. Incidence rates for both lung and colorectal cancers in men have declined in recent years. After increasing from 1994 to 1999, breast cancer incidence rates in women decreased by 2% per year from 1999 to 2006, likely due in part to a reduction in use of hormone replacement therapy and a slight decline or stabilization in mammography utilization. However, close inspection of the data show that in the last 4 years, rates have remained relatively unchanged. Similarly, although incidence of lung cancer has increased slightly by 0.4% per year since 1991, rates in the most recent years have plateaued. Colorectal cancer incidence rates have been decreasing rapidly by 2.2% per year since 1998. Cancer incidence rates, however, remain consistently higher in African American than white men. In contrast, cancer incidence rates are generally higher in white women than African American women, although the difference is not as great. Finally, the reports present information on cancer survival. The survival rates for all cancers combined and for certain site-specific cancers have improved significantly since the 1970s, due in part to both earlier detection and advances in treatment. Survival rates markedly increased for cancers of the prostate, breast, colon and rectum, and leukemia. With new treatment techniques and increased utilization of screening, there is hope for even greater improvements in the near future. Childhood cancer survival rates have improved at an even faster rate than survival rates for adult cancers. For example, among children ages 10 to 14 years, the 5-year relative survival rate increased from 58.9% for those diagnosed in 1975 through 77 to 80.8% for those patients diagnosed in 1999 through 2005. Researchers attribute these differences to a number of factors, including widespread participation in clinical trials among pediatric patients. Thank you for your attention to this presentation, and we hope that you'll look more closely at our publications, where there's a wealth of additional information. Thank you.